Of those things which God had created in the beginning, man was last to come into the world of being. It was not to be looked for that the ruler should appear before the subjects of his rule. But when his dominion was prepared, the next step was that the king should be manifested. When, then, the maker of all had prepared beforehand, as it were, a royal lodging for the future king, and this was the land, and islands, and sea, and the heaven arching like a roof over them, and when all kinds of wealth had been stored in this palace, and by wealth, I mean the whole creation, all that is in plants and trees, and all that has sense, and breath, and life, and if we are to account materials also as wealth, all that for their beauty are reckoned precious in the eyes of men, as gold and silver, and the substances of your jewels which men delight in having concealed, I say, abundance of all these also in the bosom of the earth, as in a royal treasure house. He thus manifests man in the world, to be the beholder of some of the wonders therein, and the lord of others, that by his enjoyment, he might have knowledge of the giver, and by the beauty and majesty of the things he saw, might trace out that power of the maker, which is beyond speech and language. For this reason man was brought into the world last after the creation, not being rejected to the last as worthless, but as one whom it behooved to be king over his subjects at his very birth. And as a good host does not bring his to his house before the preparation of his feast, but, when he has made all due preparation, and decked with their proper adornments his house, his couches, his table, brings his home when things suitable for his refreshment are in readiness, in the same manner the rich and munificent entertainer of our nature, when he had decked the habitation with beauties of every kind, and prepared this great and varied banquet, then introduced man, assigning to him as his task not the acquiring of what was not there, but the enjoyment of the things which were there, and for this reason, he gives him as foundations the instincts of a twofold organization, blending the divine with the earthy, that by means of both, he may be naturally and properly disposed to each enjoyment, enjoying God by means of his more divine nature, and the good things of earth, by the sense that is akin to them.